So now we're going to transfer our funds from local bitcoins into the BTC exchange. So I'll just go to local bitcoins and log in. Okay, so put my username, password. Okay, here we go. And there's the wallet with, this is an online wallet rather than like with our peer coins, we've got an offline wallet, or at least on our computer, we've got a software wallet rather than this online wallet, which is the local my local Bitcoins wallet. So click on the wallet, there's our funds. And now I'm going to send these Bitcoins to this account here. And so it says here where to send it. So I'm just going to copy it from here. You can generate a new address if you want to, you know, change the address that you send Bitcoins to. Some people want to, like, are concerned about their anonymity, and I think that might help you maintain that, but I'm not bothered. So I can put the receiving Bitcoin address, paste it in there, and because the numbers quite the letters are quite long, I just checked the first three are the right ones, LH9 and WFN, the last three LH. All right, okay, scroll back here. Okay, 1LH, there you go. And the last three is WFN. 1LH, WFN, yeah. I just paranoid. I sent it to the wrong place otherwise. Because you've got to be careful because you can't go back on the transaction. So now I'm going to put all of my Bitcoins, 0.373. And then I'm going to put my password. And then I'm going to send it. So click on send. Bitcoin sent successfully to address. Okay, so it takes a little while to go through. In fact, it takes quite a while to go through because this transaction needs to be confirmed. So what we can do to check on its status is to go here to blockchain info. And so on this site, when you click on it, in this section here, in search, you can get your address where you've sent it to. So you've sent it to this address. And to check up on the status, you can just put that into here. It says you may enter a block height address block. So mine's address. So I'm going to search for this address. And now it's going to say address, no transactions, nothing received, nothing. So nothing's happened so far. If I refresh, and hopefully at some point soon, it will come through. So I guess I'll pause the video and wait for this to go through. Okay, so it took about 2-3 minutes, and now by pressing refresh, you can see that the first sign of this transaction has come through on blockchain.info. So you can see there's the address I'm sending to. This is some details of where it's coming from, where it's going to. I don't know, it's a bit complicated why it's been put into different amounts, but the important bit here is says here unconfirmed transaction. Basically, you got to keep waiting until there's usually 6 confirmed transactions until you know that everything's gone through okay. But with BTC, I believe that they will accept 3 confirmations before you're able to use the funds. It says enrollment takes place within 1 minute after the 3 confirmation or transaction in the network. So I'm going to pause this video and wait for all the transactions to be confirmed. And then hopefully we should have the amount that we sent from local Bitcoins into BTCe. One other point to make is that the amounts that you send, I think I sent 0.0373. It might not be the exact amount you receive. That's because each Bitcoin transaction incurs a transaction fee, which is not from any of these exchanges. It's actually the way that Bitcoin works, that the people that are confirming the transactions get rewarded for it. And I think that's called mining. So that's why it's only a really small amount, nothing to be worried about. But yeah, so I'm going to stop this video. And in the next video, we'll have our Bitcoins and be able to use it to trade here on BTC exchange.